Maybe you sat beside the bedside and saw them breathe their last. And I experienced it last summer, last August. My wife and I wasn't at a bedside, but she went on to be with the Lord. Our last words to each other were, I love you. See you later. I love you. See you later. And y'all, last words are important, especially during a time like that, because they give us a sense of memory, a sense of remembrance. And I know I'll remember those words forever. Well, if you've been in that situation, I know you remember those words forever, because they take on a new meaning when the person has passed away. Jesus is here on the cross speaking his last words. And there's no doubt Jesus knew that we would need these last words in a time like this.
Amen.
Coming out of COVID,
Amen.
Looking at world war on the crest. Jesus knew that in a time like this, even in 2022, we would need his last words to bring us a sense of comfort. And his words are so powerful, y'all. So powerful. That he spoke them 2,000 years ago. But they have the same power.
Amen.
Is anybody glad that the word of God still has power? So Jesus' words still have power even in our lives today.
Amen.
It is finished. I believe, again, I'm biased, that these were the most poignant and the most important. Only in John 19:30 do we find it stated like this. Jesus came, the ultimate and the final sacrifice for our sin. Yes. And in the Greek, that verse finished, that word finished, that phrase finished, is tetelestai. Mm. I got it right.
Yeah.
I've said it all night. It means that the debt has been paid in full. Greek is a little more advanced than English.
Right.
The tense of the word means that not only was it finished for that moment, but it's finished for the rest of time. Is anybody glad about that? The uniqueness of the way that it was put, that the writer fashioned it out, let us know that it is complete and it is finished. I'll tell you what that is in just a moment. But the Bible says that Jesus yelled it out. He screamed it out. Somebody said, well, he was in pain. Could have been. So somebody said, well, the people were away. Could have been. But I believe he was putting hell and the devil on notice. I believe he screamed and he yelled it because he wanted the devil to know you have no reign over the rest of the
world.
He wanted death and hell to know your reign has ended.
Amen.
So the Bible says he yelled it out. The ESV study Bible puts it like this. It is finished proclaims that all the work that the Father had sent Jesus to do was accomplished at that moment.
That's right.
It was complete. Particularly his penalty for paying for our sins. Y'all, did y'all hear that?
Amen.
Not his sins. Our sins. And his suffering had a purpose. His suffering had a point. Jesus saying, it is finished, says that the debt that was created by Adam in the Garden of Eden was now paid in full.
Thank you, Lord.
Done.
Thank you, Lord.
Complete. Finished. Finito. However you want to say it, it is done. Y'all hear this? It resonates a little deeper than that. Because not only did he take away man's sin, but my Bible says he removes it from as far as the east is from the west. Never to meet again. It is finished, it's done, it's signed, it's sealed. Why? Because of the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
He came, y'all, to pay it in full.
Amen. Thank you.
Not part of it, not a piece of it. The entire penalty for sin. Sins committed before, sins that were being committed right then, and is anybody glad?
Yes.
Sins that would be committed.
Hallelujah.
And is anybody glad about that? It is complete. But then, let me get theological here for a moment. Jesus fulfilled all prophecy. When he said it is finished, every Old Testament prophecy about him was complete. All the symbols, all the foreshadowing, everything was complete in Jesus.
Amen.
From the beginning of Genesis to the end of Malachi. If you look, you'll find 300 detailed prophecies about the anointed one and his anointing. From Genesis 3:15, where he said the seed would crush the serpent's head, all the way to Isaiah 53.
Amen.
Talks about the suffering servant. So finally, what does it mean, big picture? It means when Jesus said it is finished, that he, watch this, y'all, provides the only solution for us to get back to God.
Amen.
The only solution. So there are a lot of religions out there today. Y'all, if it doesn't talk about Jesus getting us back to God, it's counterfeit.
Amen.
Don't believe it. Don't go for it. Don't go that route. He's the only way. John 14:6. Acts 4:12. Bear that fact out. But it's only through the death, resurrection of Jesus Christ,
amen,
that we are able to enjoy eternal life.
Amen.
Colossians 3:5-14 tells us that Jesus paid the debt you and I could not pay.
That's right.
On our own. What else does it mean? It means that the power of sin and Satan are finished.
Amen.
Well, I should have about 5 or 6 amens. The power of sin, death, Satan were completed on Calvary's cross. Never to be done again. His blood is just that powerful.
Amen.
And finally, the finished work, what does it mean for us? It means that you and I have new life.
Amen.
Ephesians 2:1-5. That's one of my favorite passages of scripture right there. It says, verse 1 says, and he made alive who, talking about us, were dead in trespasses and sin.
Yeah.
One of the greatest verses in the Bible. 4:5 says, but God.
But God.
Y'all know this verse? Who is rich in mercy. Because of his great love that he loved us, even while we were dead in trespasses and sin, made us alive together with Christ.
Hallelujah.
Y'all know that scripture?
Hallelujah.
And when Jesus says, by grace are you saved.
Yeah.
Not by your intellect, not by your knowledge, not by who you know. It's by grace that we've been saved. So, what does it mean? What does it mean? Big picture, it means those things, but one thing else it means is that we don't have to fear physical or eternal death. Why? Because Jesus has set us up to live with him forever. Is anybody glad about that? He told a story in Luke 11:21-22 about the strong man. He was talking about death and all those things that is now Jesus conquered all of that. He got the strong man and his house. There was nothing that escaped Jesus' power when he went down into that grave.
Amen.
And got up. Well, I feel the Holy Ghost coming on now. With all power in his hands. Yeah, do that in the Baptist church later. Yeah. Okay. But then, finally, y'all, what do the words, it is finished? Well, what do they mean for us today in the body of Christ? It means that Christ has overcome, that he won the victory, and that through him we are more than conquerors. It is finished means we have been set free. It is finished means that he paid the price on our behalf. It is finished means that love of God, given through Christ Jesus. It means, y'all, that it's a free gift. All you have to do is receive it. It is finished means the way has been cleared. All obstacles removed. It is finished means we don't have to live under the weight of condemnation and guilt in our past. We are free.
yes.
that we can ever imagine.
Amen.
It
Amen.
Is finished.
Yeah.
I'm from Green County. Back in my day, we used to play Putnam. They're pretty good now. I can't say anything right now that's really good. But y'all, when the cheerleaders wanted to rattle up the crowd, they had certain cheers
Amen.
That they would do. They wouldn't just do them once. Mm-hmm. They would do them over and over again.
Amen.
And there were certain cheers that made people want to get up because they really wanted to urge their team on. They really wanted their team to win. Y'all know what? We've won through Jesus.
Come on.
Amen.
And he said, it is finished. So y'all, this is a Friday night. That's right now they told us. This is a Friday night, give me y'all. Let's pretend we're at the football game or the basketball game or we're cheering on our favorite team. Come on, y'all, let's cheer on Jesus. Holy Father, we thank you.